Hello, this is Gio, and look at what we have here. We have a ceiling fan with four lights and white bell shades that come off of them. And you can see right there, one's broken. One's missing right now, but I actually removed that earlier so I can try to get a replacement. And I'll show you that. Okay, so I took this one down. That's the one that's missing. And I went to Home Depot to try to find a replacement. I got one similar, you can see here, but the closest one was just slightly larger. And this occurs commonly when you're trying to replace this. Sometimes you could find an exact match, sometimes not. Maybe, if you might want to say, okay, well, I'll just replace that and won't look too bad. But in this case, I actually purchased four new bell shades, so I'm gonna replace all four of them. This can be add a lot of cost, but sometimes if you want to look nice, you have to do that. Again, if you can match the existing one perfectly, that'd be optimal. You only have to buy one. But in this case, we had to buy four. So we have to climb up there, but before you do that, you want a nice sturdy platform. We have a little step ladder here. You can use a chair if you feel comfortable, but those could be a little unstable. I recommend getting a nice step stool, and we'll go ahead and climb up here. So removing these from the ceiling, you do kind of want to have some gloves because it can cut you. You want to first just remove the light that's inside here. Put that aside and very carefully loosen the screws. You don't have to, in this case, there's three screws holding this bell glass in. You don't have to remove the screws all the way. If they do come out, you could just replace them, but usually there's a little give, and so if you screw them back a little bit, they'll just come out right away, and we'll go ahead and discard this one. And here's a close-up. You can see how the screws work. You just loosen them up there and they kind of back out. Again, if they come out all the way, you just stick them back in. And probably just loosening two of them will allow the glass to be removed, and just keep it back a little bit when we replace it. Okay, so we're gonna replace it with the new bell glass. Again, I don't have gloves on right now. You can be, it's a little sharp right here if you want to put gloves, but it's a little easier for me to put this on. And again, just kind of back out at least a couple of those screws, and then kind of slip it in just like that. And make sure it's in all the way. And what you're trying to do is, if you can see this here, let me show you. It has a little bit of a groove here, so when you screw those screws in, it'll kind of catch right here and prevent it from falling out. So if you're too high, it won't catch it properly and it could fall out. So make sure that the screw is right at this little groove here. And if you don't have these backed up enough, it may not fit properly. So we're just going to screw this in until it just touches, and I'm kind of wiggling it a little bit to make sure it's in the groove, so it's not coming out. And I'm just going to tighten just, I mean, I'm just basically touching it to the glass. I'm not really putting a lot of pressure in. If you screw it too much, it could crack and break the glass. So really, all you need is to touch the screw to the glass, and even if it wiggles a little bit like this, that's fine, as long as it's in there. And so we got that in there. And then I'm just going to replace the bulb. Now again, I did mention earlier, I did turn off the power, so make sure that the power's off before you do any of this. And there you go, I just tested the light, and so everything works okay. You can see it's a little bit longer there. And if you're okay with that look, that's fine. You could just purchase one of these, but I'm going to go ahead and replace all four. And there you go. They're all replaced, all looking good. Well, I hope this video helped you out. Good luck on your project, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.